roles for women have improved considerably over the last few years. Even in films that celebrate the male protagonist, women aren't necessarily relegated to the sidelines. In 2019 alone, some of our finest actresses created opportunities for themselves to play inspiring real-life figures. Others put their strength behind stories that they cared strongly about.
Scene 76, shot one, take one.
In Son Chidiya, Bhumi Pednekar invoked empathy and introspection, playing a victim of domestic abuse, determined to end the cycle of patriarchal oppression. In Sand Ki Aankh, she was both funny and fierce as the sexagenarian shooter who dreams of a better life for her granddaughter. In Bala, she refused to let the color of her skin decide her fate. In Pati Patni Aur Vo, she refused to turn the other way when her husband strayed. Taapsee Pannu did much of the heavy lifting in Badla, playing a married woman accused of murdering her lover. In Sand Ki Aankh, she delivered a feisty performance as the granny who picks up the gun, challenging patriarchy with gumption and witty lines.
Action!
What is Gully Boy without spunky Safina? Alia Bhatt invested the Spitfire with passion and rage. A young woman as unwilling to give up her education as she is inflexible on the matter of sharing her boyfriend. Vidya Balan gracefully conveyed the superpowers of a working mother in Mission Mangal, successfully balancing domestic life with a demanding career in space research, frequently employing kitchen tricks to pull off the Mars mission. And Yami Gautam provided the chuckles in Bala, playing a ditzy TikTok star with shallow ambitions. Armed with humor and sincerity, she imbued her vain, superficial character with genuine likability. The five women who delivered some of the strongest performances on screen this year spoke honestly and openly about what it's like to be constantly judged and undermined, about the need for a sensitive shooting environment in order to perform to one's best ability, and what they really thought about that polarizing film, Kabir Singh. Leaving political correctness at the door, the ladies let their guard down when they assembled for the Actresses Roundtable. Ladies, this is so exciting. You created some of the most fascinating women on screen this year. You humanized such fascinating women. You created such interesting women. You took us inside the heads and hearts of women who, on the surface, may have seemed like one thing, but you revealed them to be layered and complex and really interesting. So, first and foremost, thank you.
Thank you.
I want to start by asking you the same question that we began the Actors Roundtable with. What was that one scene or that one moment in each of your films, in your respective films, that represents the reason why you wanted to do that film?
Wow.
Wow, interesting.
Yeah, I haven't thought of that now.
Rather a homework. Come on, let's take a big break now.
And in the case of y'all who've had multiple
Yeah, races, let's think. Bhumi, let's have a rewind of the year for us.
Yami, you want to go?
I think Yami would go first.
Okay, do I look really prepared?
Did he share the question with you before?
For me, it's got to be, I'm sorry, I think you're yet to watch the film, but I'll just
please
talk about it. The scene where she tells Bala, where Pari tells Bala that why she is the way she is.
Right.
You know, and because that scene is such a contrast to overall the arc that character
Correct.
Has, which is ditzy, she's funny, she's filmy, she's drama and whatever, all those things that made Pari.
Right.
But that scene is an altogether different side to her.
Right.
And for some reason, that scene justifies her decision, whatever
Correct.
She
Who
stands
she is
by.
And what she's saying, yeah.
So as a performer, I thought that's that whole layering that you're talking about. And, you know, it feels, as a performer, there was so much in that scene, in that one monologue which she has, which I think underlines in a very subtle, yet in a very definite sort of a way what the film was trying to say.
Right. And you recognized that the moment it was narrated to you, the moment you got the script?
Yes, that's the first scene actually also that we read. And I had no idea about the script. I just knew the concept. But when I read that scene, I could see that character. It was very clear in my head what I would, how I would like to portray that character on screen.
Okay.
Yeah, go for it.
Now it's my. Are we going clockwise? Well, honestly, I don't remember a particular moment in the narration with Zoya where I realized, okay, this is the reason I'm doing the film. There was a sort of overall feeling that I was left with when I heard the full film, and I had tears in my eyes, and that was kind of it. But I remember there was a moment where I went like, are you serious about Safina?
Uh-huh.
Was when, because it just kind of came back to back, where she meets Murad on the bus, and then she goes and beats up that girl, and then she, you know, lies about it in the clinic, and then she like screams at Murad. So I was like, are you, is this the way it is?
I love that scene where you went and broke the bottle. I just loved it.
For me, all those scenes were extremely exciting. But it was only the overall feeling that I felt at the end of the film that made me feel like I have to be a part of this journey.
Okay.
For me, yeah, I think it was a very well-written script, a very wholesome character, you know, because you could mistake her for a regular homemaker, and then she turns out to be a scientist.
Right.
So, but I think importantly, if I had to pick, there was this one scene where I'm telling my son that, you know, pray to the power, not to the picture. Mm. And I think it encapsulated the entire belief system behind even, you know, I'd always wondered if scientists believed in God or in a power. Yeah. And I think that kind of helped me reconcile that question. And the entire film, you know, because we were pitted against film as in the mission, faced insurmountable obstacles. But the way, I think it's the belief that made it possible.
Mm.
So I think that one scene just stuck in my head and I was like, this is part me, part the character.
Right.
You know, I wanted to feel that scene. I wanted to feel how I'd do it. I didn't know how I'd do it.
Mm.
It's a very simple scene. There's nothing, it's just two of us talking. But
right.
I thought that really captured the essence of everything for me. The mission, her personality, the story.
From Badla, I thought that's, first of all, the fact that she is like an onion peel.
Yeah.
It just keeps on changing. And then the moment where now she has confessed that she's done it to this man who's been constantly saying, you're paying me money for it, you better say the truth. You're paying money for it. And he's always overpowering her.
Right.
Now she has flipped it. And now she's like, I am paying you money for it. Now save me.
Right.
So that is that was the moment where I thought, okay, now this is nice turnover. I'm enjoying it. And in Saand Ki Aankh, I think that interval scene did it for me. When my character and Bhumi's character, we both of us are telling our daughters, granddaughter, that we haven't seen Taj, we haven't traveled in plane, we haven't done all this, but we'll make sure you're going to do this.
Wow.
Yeah.
So that, I think, did it for me. Because I could picturize my mom there, and that's how we both did it. That did it for me.
Okay.
Where Son Chirya is concerned, I think my experience with Son Chirya is very similar to what Alia's was with Gully Boy, because when Chobi narrated the script to me, I was like, I just want to be a part of the story.
Mm.
But particularly my introduction scene was something that I was blown away by, because there's this woman, you know, who's on the run with this little girl.
Right.
And she has a gun in her hand. And the moment she meets these goons and these dacoits, she puts her ghoongat down and her gun up.
But
That just describe the world to me, that just describe the dichotomy of both the sexes, how different their worlds are, and how tough is it for a woman even today to exist, you know, because even though Son Chirya is set in the 70s, you know, the situation isn't very different now. And
clearly,
I think, yeah, and where Saand Ki Aankh is concerned, I think the scene is the same. The interval scene where we are speaking to our daughters, oh my God. I remember Taapsee and I, we like prepped the entire day, and I was just like, we kept thinking of our moms. But that just literally summarizes what your mother does for you, what a parent does for you. And you know, that the film was a tribute to our mothers. But there's another scene in the film that I completely love, where my character, she rather doesn't play a match. And on purpose, Taapsee's character also loses that match. Mm. And it was just, it's such a true tale of sisterhood and celebrating womanhood.
Rarely seen
It's rarely seen. Yeah. And that's the crux of the film. And when I read that scene, I said, listen, there's too much heart in it. Mm. You know, so I was sold. Sure. And where Bala is concerned, I think the most exciting part about Bala for me was that I wasn't playing Ayushman's love interest. Because we've done that. You know, we've done that in two very successful films. So there's this scene where I start picking on him because, you know, he's so conscious of his hair situation. Yeah. And when Amar narrated that scene to me, I said, this is exactly what I want to do. Because of this Tom and Jerry relationship that they have, this constant one-up, I said,
You know, to each of you, when you're lucky enough to get a great script and you start reading it, do you hear yourself as the character? Do you see yourself as the character? Do you feel yourself as the character? Can you describe that process when you're either hearing a narration that you're enjoying or reading a script that you're really enjoying? At what point do you start sort of listening to it or reading yourself sounding like that character?
I think from the beginning.
I think it varies. Like when the narration is going well, like, it always starts with you imagining yourself in that place. And if it's a good narration or a good reading, then it stays till the end.
You're still looking at yourself. Yeah. Otherwise, you are just...
Otherwise, it's like, arey nahi, abhi kuch deflect ho gaya. It's like almost somebody came and stood in the middle and said, toodles. So, it's like, that happens from the beginning. You have to imagine. Otherwise...
But I have to tell you, for the longest time, I imagined myself in the roles of the male hero. And I was like,
I love it.
Yeah.
So it was everything for the disappointment.
Why? You know
what? I did that in Badla.
I love it.
I was offered something else. I was imagining myself in that role in Badla.
Yeah, it's crazy because sometimes those roles were, I'm talking about at least up
in the start, sure.
Maybe 10 years ago. But I would be like, but that character is so well written. You know, mine's not really well fleshed out. So I would naturally, instinctively veer towards that and then realize that I couldn't play that, you know. And thank God for Small Mercies that things changed. Yeah. And our roles started getting written better.
Each of you, is that it?
I think it happens. It happens exactly when you, the moment you connect with it. Like I start imagining, you start imagining the scene, you start imagining. I think I get too graphical also. Maybe I give some expressions which probably has happened in one or two narrations. They're like, are you smiling? I said, no, I'm just imagining.
In your own head.
It happens.
And sometimes you just don't you know. And those are the most painful.
But it always starts off with you imagining and then somewhere down the line.
There's a disconnect.
No, but sometimes, I don't know whether it's the energy of the person or whether that's he or she is a bad narrator. I've sat through narrations and been like,
you know what I've done in a narration? I tell this story to people and like I have gone inside my kitchen twice in the middle of a narration, emptied a pack of coffee powder in my mouth. Because there was no one to make coffee at
but
home.
But do you know but that it needs water?
I needed instant help.
And maybe, sometimes the subject is so, you're so far away from it. Yeah. Like you find no...
No, but it's the toughest when they are, like the people that are narrating it, they obviously are very attached to their material, right? So they are having a ball. They think they've hit it out of the park. And they probably have. You're just not connecting with the material. And those times I'm literally like, Bhumi, just be awake. Like, you know, just look interested.
Have you had funny narrations? I have narrations. This one director rolling on my floor. Explaining a fall and how she's going to...
Wow, that's so cute.
I've had the director's heart after that.
He left sweet. I find
he left
so
from my living room to balcony to explain an exit.
That's so passionate.
Good time looking at
it. No, but I always feel that, you know, I don't know if I can judge a script. Mm. I always go by whether I can connect with it or not.
Right.
Because that's the only thing
I feel within the first 20, 15, 20 minutes.
You know. No, but I know whether I'm connecting or not.
Yeah, exactly.
Whether
you're connecting.
Whether I can't tell whether it's a good script or not. And I always tell people it's...
Exactly how you said it also depends on the person. Because sometimes it's your own gut. And sometimes it's that faith that's... you derive from that person.
Yeah,
that
exactly.
Something
that person's vision sometimes...
Exactly.
Actually, that was... Yeah. You know, there been a time when you've said... no to a film, to a script, but been convinced by the filmmaker's passion, vision, you know, that person has changed your mind or maybe just given you a new way to look at it and it worked out.
Yeah. And you did it. I mean,
and maybe you did
done it.
Yeah.
That's never happened with me. I don't know. I've never said no and been I don't people convince also. Like, I think once you say no, at least this happened with me, right, that there is like a, okay, fine. Like, you know, right, we respect that decision. And also, I don't think you should convince an actor if they're not 100% convinced. I don't know. Unless it's like a story idea which kind of develops through time and it's not a full-fledged script narration or a reading or something like that.
No, exactly. I feel that, you know, it's pointless to try to convince someone who doesn't see themselves in the role or is not feeling strongly about the story. I always tell people, you know, I'm not feeling it, so please. Because there are times when people try and convince you, but I'm always like, you know, just let it go because I'm not going to be able to do my best. But Power was an exception. Power for different reasons, because it was a very big decision for me to play mother to, you know, a 13-year-old.
Exactly, like decisions and, like this. Like, you know, where you feel like, okay, like for example, Sand Ki Aankh, it came to me thrice.
Right.
And it was the fourth time. And every time I heard the film, I read it and it didn't work out, I felt really bad. I was like, Bhumi, why? Like, you know, but there was just this, I was just scared. I was very, very nervous. I was like, what if I just screw it up? You know, I'm really putting myself out there. It's not an easy thing to do. But then I realized that if you're feeling this bad, and I literally felt like a sense of loss, I was like, no, I have to do the film. So probably Sand Ki Aankh is the only film that I've said no to, and it kept coming back to me. And thank God, I think it's one of the most heartwarming films of my career. You know, so apart from that, I don't think there's ever been a time that I've not connected with the material. And the times that we have, like, there, you know, directors really reach out to you and they're like, no, hum aise project set karenge, hum wo karenge, wo karenge. But I don't think a film can be set up, you know, and a performance cannot be set up. So either you connect with it or you don't.
I think it happened during Badlapur, although I know it was a cameo.
Yeah.
But I was playing a mother to a 5-year-old and it was a very different concept. Of course, I'd do anything to work with, you know, Sri Ram Raghavan. And it was a very interesting script, I mean, for its time.
Yeah.
But for me, at that point of time, to do a cameo and to play a mother, it wasn't sort of, I wasn't able to see myself in that. And then that's when it came back to me and they said, you know what, you're just seeing only one side of it, but you're getting to work with Sri Ram on a subject which has never been explored. And if you're playing a mother to a 5-year-old, so is Varun playing, who's as young as you, you know, a father. And it is not that kind of a story. So, yeah, it does exceptional situations. And I think you can obviously revisit your decision. But overall, I think it's something which we all go by instinct. And if you don't connect with it, it's always for a reason.
Sure.
Yeah. You probably can't explain it. You can't express it.
Yeah.
But there's always something that will that'll actually guide you on the right track, that if you said no to something.
I also think it's state of mind.
Yeah.
You know, I've experienced it so many times that I've come across wonderful scripts and I've said, why is it that I'm not feeling it? But I don't have an answer.
Yeah.
And then, you know, I tend to choose something else over it,
right,
which speaks to me more strongly. And
yeah, but that happens. Like, sometimes you hear scripts or read scripts and you say, it was really nice and you should make this film. And as an audience, I would really enjoy it. But maybe I'm not looking at this kind of part right now.
Correct.
Which is okay. And I also feel like, you know, everybody, because it's in the creative business, and everybody is more than understanding about your responses. Even sometimes, even if they're pushy, maybe they're pushy because they see a certain potential in you which you've not been able to kind of see yet. So actually, I love the discussions that happen post, you know,
narration.
I mean, not all, sometimes even with yourself, the discussions are very interesting.
Correct.
because you will get to learn so much. And then when you see the film finally, you're like, oh, I had felt this. And sometimes you're wrong, sometimes you're right.
Right.
So it's very interesting.
Alia, you know, your director Zoya Akhtar has said that the character of Safina was entirely co-writer Reema Kakti's creation. She said she had created this character for another
film,
project that she was doing. This character of this young girl who's crazy about this about her boyfriend, but she's got a lot of anger in her.
Yeah.
Possibly because she feels oppressed at home. She wants to study. Yeah. The family, her mother is against her studying. Her mother wants her to get married. When you're playing someone like that, who's got that much anger in her, or a character like Urta Punjab, where she's holding back so much pain, what are you tapping into? Where, how are you channeling those emotions? What, you know, how do you get into that zone?
I've never tapped into, I mean, I would not say never, but I don't think I've ever tapped into personal experiences while I'm doing, performing a scene. Like, for example, for Safina, I just had fun. Like, there was no, like, over kind of thinking about the anger part. I feel like I'm a very expressive person, even in my personal life, in terms of, like, if I'm irritable, I'll just snap like that. And then I'll feel bad about it, but I'll snap. So I just snapped, and I snapped extensively while I was doing those scenes. And I remember, like, it's all in the writing. There's nothing for you. You don't have to do anything. You just have to, if it's like, okay, she says, you know, tu shukar kar uska gardan nahi todi main. You know, now how would you say that line? That's written. It's written for you. There's only one way to say it. I mean, in my head. And that's all, like, we just derived a few words. We did a workshop, which is the first time I ever done a workshop, that, okay, in this scene, she's acting from this place. She's, right now, she's possessive. Right now, she's vulnerable. Right now, she's like, I just, you know, I don't give a damn. So, that's it. There was no, like, tapping into some deep-seated anger that I had within me. All that didn't happen.
Okay.
I love her answer. Yeah. Yeah, sometimes things are really simple.
Right,
You know, so it's nice, you know.
It's really not rocket science. You just go, you do. I think acting is just about doing. Being there at that moment.
Right. Present in the moment.
Just, and pretend.
Just doing it.
I do love it.
Just, like, happens.
I feel like this new world only gets created. Yeah. So actually, I love acting. I don't know whether this happens to you guys. I love performing in my actor's close-up. Because then there's nothing in front of me.
I love it.
So I have most fun then. There's no camera, there's nothing. So I'm it's real.
I end up firing everyone on my eyeline anyway.
Yeah.
Bhumi has seen this in person. I'm like, and by the half of the film gets over, everyone is already petrified. The moment my close-up happens, they're like, better not see. The cameraman is also asking, should I start there?
You know, some of you have done biopics or are playing characters based on real people. Vidya, you of course done The Dirty Picture. You're playing Shakuntala Devi in your next film. Alia, I know that Shakun has you down for playing Ma Sheela, Bhumi, Taapsee. I'm not even asking.
You said the same thing last round.
But I, you know, we're sometimes we're privileged to know some inside information. The two of you, Bhumi, Taapsee, you all played those characters in Saan Ki Aankh. My question is, as an actor, having the ability to go back and research and read about that character, about that person, at what point is that a hindrance? Of course, it's a great help to have that information and to have that research. But at what point does that become as much of a liability as it is a benefit?
I think...
And in your cases, you all had the women on set.
Yeah, we did. But I think, honestly, having them around was very comforting, because what we kind of showed in the film was a lot of, they're very maternal as people. And I don't think that's something that we could channelize without experiencing it to that level. You know, for me, it wasn't a hindrance, because I really read up on them. And I knew about both the shooter dadis. I mean, they are quite cool. But what really helped me was the fact that, you know, I had this image ki acha gaon ki aurat hogi, to aisi hogi. But they really shattered that for me, because they are funny. They were so progressive. They were like just cool. You know, of course, they are strong and they have a lot of courage, but they are just cool women. You know, they joke around, they fun around, they'll pick on you, they'll like feed you, they'll give you love. So I was like, okay, let me break the stereotype that I have in my head of what a dadi is. Sweet, pyari. No, she's witty. She's badass.
Right.
So it really helped me. At least, like, where the shooter dadis are concerned, I think whatever information we could get was really
helpful.
Yeah, definitely.
And I think a hindrance is only a hindrance if you see it like a hindrance.
Right, right.
It actually helps us define certain boundaries and help us maneuver our direction, you know, in the right way rather, you know, this is the way you should go about it. So I didn't really see it as a hindrance. I saw it like boundary that will help me define my path towards reaching it out. I didn't see it as a hindrance.
And if I just have to, like, can add another thing, I think, you know, what happened on set was there were certain things that I took from Chandro Dadi. There were certain things that I left. There were certain things that she took. Like, for me, I tried being closer to the way she behaves physically. You know, Taapsee had her version of what Prakashi Dadi did. So what she said is absolutely on point, that, you know, it depends on what limitations you want to set for your character and what aspects you want to pick up.
You know, for Shakuntala particularly now, I've read up so much. There are so many videos. I think I went through all of them. And at some point I said, you know, I've got a sense of the person. Mm. I know now whether this is how she'll react in a certain situation. If the script is feeling, you know, organic, if her reactions in a particular scene are feeling organic, that's when I say enough.
Right.
When I have a sense of the person, you know, when I feel like, oh, she has blood and bones.
Correct.
Correct.
Because I also didn't have, she's no more.
No more, right, right.
And with Silk, I think it was...
That must have been really tough.
Yeah, that was... Because for me, it was, I keep saying this, it was an out-of-body experience, you know. I'm a certain person in my body and I have to be a completely different person. And I knew I could do it as an actor.
Mm.
But that sense of abandon that I needed, I could only do by constantly telling myself that, you know, don't judge her. And I remember I would go to Milan's office all the time and sit in front of him. He would run away. He would be like, there's nothing to be said. Because I'd go for my rehearsals to his office and in the floor below. And then I'd go up and say, you know, can we talk? And he'd say nothing. Just don't judge her. And I'd be like, that's so helpful. Thank you very much. But actually, that's the only thing that helped. Because, you know, her videos also don't really give you a sense of
right.
who she could who have been off beyond, camera.
Correct, correct. Beyond what you see on
so
screen.
So I think it was just that. And then I enjoyed playing her.
Mm. Do you all worry, I mean, Yami, Alia, do you all, are you anxious about the time that you have to do that you have to play someone that, I mean, are you curious, are you anxious, are you excited about when that opportunity comes along?
Well, I'm sort of doing it in Gangubai as
correct.
Well, although we haven't seen too much of Gangubai, it's a name we've heard, a story we don't know of, but again, I also feel like, you know, to not speak too much about the process and stuff, it totally depends on the way your filmmaker wants you to portray that particular character. Like, I'm sure it must be very different for, say, Ranveer Singh, who has to play Kapil Dev in 83.
Correct.
He has to, like...
It's also very well-known, yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's like, it's uncanny, the
correct.
Resemblance.
Correct.
I mean, now to get that, to achieve that is unbelievable. That's
yeah.
a different kind of art.
Right.
But when you're playing a part that you can mold
slightly
a bit, you can
right.
take the things the person did and the stories you've heard of the person and then... make your own character of how your director or the writer has written the script.
Mm.
Then that kind of, you know, gives you some kind of place to play around. But eventually, I think, again, it's the director's call about the way they want to tell the story. And then you have to kind of go with the flow.
Also, when it's a really well-known person, you have to guard against
yeah.
becoming a caricature.
Yeah, exactly.
It's such a fine balance. So that's where the director really...
That's, yeah. that's exactly.
Because you're not mimicking.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
You're living
not
that
mimicry.
Person.
Correct, correct.
Yeah, you,
no, but like, for example, Ranveer also in Sanju. He did that walk and
right.
he did but that little, but there was something of
exactly.
him.
Right.
That
right.
you could also
yeah.
see.
Yeah.
Exactly.
But again, I feel like it cannot exist without the director's interpretation
yeah.
and the way
right.
the director's imagining the
imagine
character.
Imagine the whole, right.
You know,
right.
you're the director's kind of voice
yeah.
at the end
yeah.
of the day.
Yami, you've said that you recognize that it took so many years after Vicky Donor for people to recognize the potential in you. You've been a part of good films like Badlapur. You've been the heroine in a Hrithik Roshan film. You've had the big blockbuster in Uri, but it took Bala for people to really recognize what you can do. And you've said that you always knew you had the potential. So therefore, you've had those dark days, those days of frustration that when will people come to terms with the fact that I can do. Can you talk about what that's like? You've said that this business can break you.
Of course it can. Actually, honestly, any business can. And I think today we're living in very tough times where we have to deal with so many things. And when I interact even with my friends who are in different industries, they're all facing some issues or the other. It's just because we're always in the limelight.
Mm.
It's just what's expected out of us is to be on our toes and to look in a certain way, to be in a certain way. You know, there was a time where it was just your films, but now
right.
you have films, you have your PR, you have your brands, you have, you're an image today.
Social media.
You're a brand
yeah.
today. You're not an actor anymore.
Correct.
And for someone like me who just overnight Vicky Donor happened, I wasn't prepared what's going to come, what's going to follow. Then suddenly you have your entourage, aapki team hai, aapki koi हजार ओपिनियन है हर एक की आपकी आपको नेक्स्ट फिल्म कैसे करनी चाहिए दिस इज़ हाउ यू शुड ड्रेस दिस इज़ हाउ यू शुड यू नो वॉक इन टू अ मीटिंग एंड आई एम लाइक व्हाट्स हैपनिंग आई थॉट आई वाज हियर जस्ट टू वर्क एंड आई नो आई एम अ गुड एक्टर बट दैट स्पेस इज सो इम्पॉर्टेंट इट टॉट मी टू बी कंफर्टेबल विद a film not doing well, what you call a failure, as much as I'm comfortable with a hit film or a performance that people are appreciating. So I think that is what it taught me. It takes experience. It takes that downfall. I wouldn't call it a downfall, but you know, my father's like, even if you want to gobble an ice cream out of your sad, just gobble it, but be happy about it. It's okay. It's fine. Because suddenly this whole burst of media, and you know, I remember I used to feel ki, arey, my last two films haven't done well because they're going to ask me now, how do you feel about it? You know, so-and-so's film's doing well, so your contemporaries, or your first act. They used to keep constantly asking about Ayushman. Why are you asking about Ayushman? I'm very happy for him, but... So I think then I actually took a little, I wouldn't call it a sabbatical, but I actually thought about it, that instead of pointing out problems, you know, this is an issue, let me just leave everything, internalize the reason why am I sitting here? What is it I'm here for? I know I'm here to do some really amazing work. I don't want to sound immodest, but I feel I'm a versatile actor. It's just a matter of that chance to be given. For that filmmaker to have faith that I can, if I can pull off an intense character like Ashima, and at that time, she was a little mature. Then you know, it was not your conventional kind of a launch where you had, you know, certain songs or you looked in a certain way. The styling was very different. And I'm so thankful to Shujita for that forever. But it took a little while for people to get that. You know, and for me also to be able to be comfortable with myself and accept. You know, there's something which you said in one of your interviews, and that's really one of the things that helped me. That success is when people accept you for what you are. That I was like, this is it. And you have to be yourself. You don't have to be like anybody. You know, people love Alia or Vidya or Taapsee or Bhumi for what they are, not because we resemble or there is any similarity with each other. We are individuals. So first I need to respect and believe in myself, that have that faith restored. And then some magic will happen. It's just a matter of some patience.
More power to you.
You know, there has been some controversy in the past year over who should be playing what characters. Taapsee and Bhumi, with regards to your roles in Saan Ki Aankh, there was an opinion that now senior actresses were being denied the chance to play even senior characters. Bhumi, a lot of people felt that it was especially inappropriate and ironic that in a film like Bala, whose message is that don't judge people on their looks, that they would artificially darken your skin to make you play a woman with a dark-skinned girl. I don't think that anyone should tell a filmmaker who he should or shouldn't cast in a film. But did these conversations make you reflect on whether there was any merit in these arguments?
I find it damn frustrating that everyone has an opinion on everything today. And you know, why can't you just keep it to yourself? What is the problem? You know, her bad.
We will keep them as casting after directors next time. What about that?
You won't get Taapsee and Bhumi, na yaar.
Right. But no, you know, look, there is of course one section that's doing it just to rile you. We know those. Yeah. We know that there is that one section. But there were, I would imagine, some, and you responded. When Nina Gupta, you know, made the same case, you responded to that because you felt that that's a voice you want to address. Did it make you change the way you felt about this?
You know, I definitely gave it a thought. But then I was like, you know, Bhumi, by the end of it, you're an actor. If there's a path that I really want to do and there's a director who believes that I can do it and it fits in my moral bracket, I will go ahead and do it. You know, it definitely, like, you know, I start thinking, should I not have aside? But no, it's not wrong. I mean, that's what we do, right? We change, we transform. If I can't do that, then why am I here? And I'm going to keep doing it, you know. And yes, having said that, there aren't enough roles written for women, period.
Right.
You know, it is not to do that much with like your weight or your age or your color, etc. You know, there is a dearth and we completely respect that. And I wish and I feel things are getting better. But don't take away opportunities from us, yeah, because we are really... there.
No, and you know, let's not forget that this is a business of cinema.
Right.
So by getting a Taapsee and a Bhumi, you know, to do Saant Ki Aankh, you just have better prospects. But the good news is that today Neena Gupta is doing wonderful work, and she's going to be able to do, you know, she's already a Badhai who has happened. There are other films that she's doing. So audiences will go in to watch her. So things are changing. But you can't, you know, I think it's just, I think it's ridiculous to expect change to happen overnight. It happens over time. We are seeing that change play out. But you can't just wish that, you know, you wake up one day 6 years or 10 years later and things are different.
Right.
See, there's also the thing of taking a risk, right? Like,
exactly.
It's when you think of Taapsee and Bhumi playing women of not their age, older, it's interesting. Oh, 20-year-olds have played this character. How interesting. Like, it's a different kind of, it's a risk for them as actors. And it's also interesting. It gives you a little bit of more of a, you know, a fun card to go and watch these women in general. Apart from the fact that they're beautiful actors at whatever age they play, but the fact that they're going, you know, beyond it, it's also more interesting. Like, for example, if you can pull it off, then why not?
Sure.
Like, if somebody were to tell me that, oh, why did you play that part in Urta Punjab? It's like that part was not ever going to be, you know, like, it didn't come to me. I went and asked Chobe, please, can I do it? And he took some time. And he said, okay, I need to imagine you like this girl. And it worked in that. So then it did well. If you can pull it off, then why not?
And we're actors, why did, and you know, I've been part of the film, tomorrow we complete 10 years, Pa. Why did no one raise an eyebrow when Mr. Bachchan played a 13-year-old Pa?
Because he pulled it off again, so it went. But at that time, there was not this whole thing of Twitter and
No, I know, but
you know,
I'm
it was a
saying,
much more sacred time.
No, I don't think it's only about that, Alia. I think it's also, you know, it's almost like we women are against each other. I don't think that's the case. No one questions why Ayushman Khurana played someone who was bald. Why didn't they cast a bald guy?
Like, I swear, after Saant Ki Aankh, the Bala experience became so heartbreaking for me because I got a lot of hate. And I
wasn't
like,
even aware of it, but
I feel men are a little bit more chill. Like, they don't go out there and be like, humne ye part kyun nahi kiya, tumne ye part kyun nahi kiya. It's right. Like,
they're only managing their own business.
Should just be like,
we're all
like,
working, we're all struggling, we're all striving to do better.
And it's not easy to put yourself out there, you know. The characters that we all do, like, they are tough parts to pull off. We work really hard, we don't slack. And there's certain amount of credibility even as an actor that we bring to that character.
Of course.
So why should an actor only be cast because of their color or because of their age? Then for them, I shouldn't be sitting here because I wasn't a naturally overweight girl before Dam Laga Ke Aisha. You know, I gained 32 kgs, and this is my argument all the time. Why didn't anybody say anything back then? You know, actors are constantly playing roles that are way younger. You know, I mean, they are never close to their real age. You know, they are never questioned. You take it as entertainment. You appreciate them. You go there. You go give their films business. But the moment you have any of us do something different, it is so difficult for you to digest. And it's very heartbreaking because, you know, we really want a certain change. You know, we really hope that our art brings that change. But then people need to stop being so frigid. You know, they need to be accepting.
And actually, and when in West, we actually laud them over their performance.
Exactly.
That how they transform for a role, they gain weight, they lose weight. You know, how a younger actor or most of the legends that have worked, they have always physically also transformed for the role.
Right.
When the same set of people laud their performances, why not us? So
in The Irishman, Robert De Niro has been de-aged. Why did they not cast someone else and then cast him in the older role?
You know? They have the means to de-age him. They have the software. No, but also I feel like in terms of Neena Aunty, like, I think she was also coming from a very genuine, pure place that she,
absolutely,
as an actor, wants to be able to get that opportunity. So I don't think one can
dismiss that.
That's why even Taapsee thought that she is the one she needs to talk to.
And
she
spoke,
love her.
But that's why I read her response,
like,
and it was beautiful. It was on point.
And I met her also after that, and she was really sweet. She's like, I'm so sorry if it came across in any of that way, and, you know, I didn't mean it. I said, ma'am, I know you've worked with you in Mulk. I mean, I've known her personally. So I'm like, ma'am, of course I know where you're coming from, and that's why my answer was for you.
Right.
Correct.
And, you know, with due respect and love for you.
But how cool is she? yeah.
True.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She's super.
Yeah.
She's
yeah.
No, but even like my mom is Nina Aunty's age.
Correct. Yeah,
and like
yeah,
even
yeah.
I see her being like, whenever like, I see the hunger within her.
Yeah.
She's getting so many opportunities that she's like, you know what? I'm playing the mother's role and it's a very good role. It's a long role.
Right.
It's not just beta, khana khalo and go.
Correct.
You know, the roles are getting
more
substantial.
Yeah. Yeah.
And
substantial
now with
roles.
Digital,
correct.
It's like another world only. Yeah, the OTT platform. It's like it's opening up so many opportunities.
And we want to see them.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah,
we want to see them in substantial roles.
You know, but that response of Shabana ma'am after our film,
fantastic.
It just sorted out a lot of things inside
yes.
us.
Right. If you
not
had any
this
kind
constant
of
conflict.
Right.
Prove it to like anyone else. It calmed
yeah.
us down when
yeah.
we saw her teary-eyed, hugged us for the longest time and just so overjoyed and wanting to tell people about the film. We were like, okay.
But again, she's so generous, you know,
yeah.
to actually do this when you like something.
Yeah.
Right.
Not too many people do
absolutely.
That. I think she's so wholeheartedly
yeah.
appreciates. I think it's wonderful, yeah.
Yeah. You know, today, it's clear that Hindi cinema has made some progress in the representation of women. You have a film like Saand Ki Aankh, which puts two women at the forefront of the story. You can make a film like Mission Mangal, where there are five women leading the narrative, and the big male star is actually the supporting role, if you like. Even in a film like Gully Boy, which is essentially the protagonist story, you have a female character who's well-etched and who's a real living, breathing person. In Bala, we see that women have agency. I mean, they make their life's
yeah.
decisions. But on the other hand, there are still some baffling decisions. Let's talk about Kabir Singh and how that made you feel. Do you feel too much is being made of it?
Yeah,
I do think so.
Sure.
Sorry.
Sure. No, 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 no.
Let you complete it.
Are we too casual about violence towards women?
We are too casual about violence in general.
Yeah.
We are too casual about that, I think.
I think, and that is what needs to be addressed.
No, but you know what I feel is that it's a film telling the story of a particular individual.
Yeah,
it's not glorifying it.
Oh, you didn't feel
I didn't
that
feel it that I didn't feel it was glorifying it at all. I don't agree with it. I didn't like the character.
Mm.
I actually hated him. And if I was in her place, I was thinking of how I'd slap him,
correct,
kick him in the groin or things like that. But you know,
but that's exactly it.
Yeah, but it's a film. And someone's chosen to tell this story. Why are we taking it so
seriously?
But like she also did slap him.
But not enough. I would have like
yeah,
gone.
Yeah, 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 definitely not enough. I was like, do something.
You haven't watched it.
I haven't watched it. And yeah, nothing against the film. But whatever, there was so much happening around it. I'm like, okay, I think I need a little time before I
right.
watch it.
Yeah, I also took some time.
Yeah.
No, I have an issue.
It just so
I mean, I, unlike Vidya, I did feel the glorification.
Yeah, I thought so. I thought it's
really?
I thought it normalizes abuse.
Did you see Arjun Reddy?
I did.
So
and it's exactly
I've not
the same
seen
thing.
Kabir Singh, I've seen Arjun Reddy.
I've seen Arjun Reddy, yes.
And my, what where I come from, I was entertained,
right.
right? And then I started questioning myself that why am I getting this entertained by this? Yes, it's a film. I completely get it. It's a flawed character. I would want to play a flawed character.
I played a flawed
but there was,
character.
I felt like there was no culmination to, I mean, there has to be some change.
Right. Repercussion.
Some
yeah.
repercussion.
For
some
that behavior.
Change.
I mean, I felt like.
Because I
but
think
but
the social
don't you
condition.
Think that there was, like he was suffering, he had become an
but see,
ally.
That's,
yeah.
That's self-inflicted. For
but
me, I mean, the problem was that at
like
the end, he's actually rewarded. That girl
yeah.
has.
Yeah,
that
girl.
Yeah.
Yeah. That girl
is
the only problem.
He gets the girl,
he gets everything.
Yeah, so you know, I would have liked for her not to go back to
exactly.
him.
Yeah,
exactly.
That
exactly.
would have happened.
Exactly.
This,
but
exactly.
that was
exactly.
Earth how
right.
many years ago? Okay, that's.
Correct.
I'm saying
I,
that's
no,
not
I
the
mean,
case, but. And I don't agree with it, but it is a story being told, yeah.
Sure.
You know,
I came out angry.
Yeah.
Mm. I wanted to, and I remember calling Shahid and I said, you know, it's a great performance
Ka.
Because...
It that's true. It,
you know...
And it makes you so angry
that.
Because it's a great
yeah.
performance.
Correct.
Yeah, yeah.
yeah. But
yeah,
I hated him.
Full conviction.
I hated him. I could have boxed him.
He's,
but...
that's exactly what...
And
that,
there are
that's
people
also,
like that,
that
which
it,
is
and
unfortunate.
And that's also the problem, isn't it? The fact that he's so good in it, the fact that is the romanticism of it. I mean, you it almost normalized. Not almost.
It
didn't
make me feel like I didn't. I don't. You know, of course, I'm not a man, but I don't think someone who's like that anyway will probably romanticize it.
Mm.
Someone who's going to abhor this kind of behavior is not going to say, "Oh wow, I should become like this."
You know the thing is,
sorry.
I was just going to say that I really feel like everyone's entitled to their opinion after the watching a film.
Yeah.
And, but it's just become like, now it's become too convenient to suggest changes, and we should have done this, or she should have done that, you should have done that. Like we were talking about the earlier thing as well, we have to draw the line. Come out of the film, you didn't like it, cool, go home.
Yeah.
Uske beyond now to keep this thing about it, like, I feel, yeah, films can influence you to a certain level. But beyond a point, at a core, you have to be a good person and you should not be
influenced by these. Like I, for example, the girl who works in my house, right, she has suffered physical abuse and it is okay for her to do that because she says that at least he's protective of me. He takes care of my children. This is the social conditioning that I have a problem with. I mean, but because I have, I mean,
and it's not just the violence, I also feel that proprietary attitude on women, you know, like marking your territory.
He goes
to that class and says, she's mine. You guys keep your eyes off. There'll be other girls.
But having said that,
I loved what Vijay did. Like he was so good as Arjun Reddy that I was invested in the film, but I as an audience think that it is a little flawed because there's so many people. I mean, I believe that there has to be some, like for example, if we speak of Joker, right? Like the film has made $1 billion. It is like an R-rated film. There's violence to a different level, but you are showing a mentally disturbed character.
Yeah.
And you're showing that what happens with him by the end of it is not a celebration of behavior that he portrays.
But even that got into a lot of controversy.
100%.
So I guess it's the time.
But I guess today people have opinions which they are voicing very freely. But I also feel, are we going towards, you know, a political correctness that's going to really curb creativity?
Are you telling
me what my voice should sound like?
Right.
That's exactly.
I have a voice.
Right.
You know, and I choose to.
Right.
Yeah, if you don't like it, don't watch it.
I completely get
your choice. I'm just saying when we are being asked.
Right.
Yeah. You have to give.
We have to tell what we feel. And if I would have been in that position, would I have done it?
Hmm.
No, I wouldn't.
You're talking about the film, or are you talking about the?
I'm talking as an actor.
Right.
Both as a person and as an actor.
I probably after I saw Arjun Reddy and after what I saw of it, I did not go and watch Kabir Singh.
Hmm.
But which is what
that's
I'm
my
saying.
Personal choice.
Yeah.
And I don't want anyone else to change their opinion because of
me.
No, but I'm saying that's what you did, right?
Yeah.
So do that. Don't go and watch it if you don't
exactly.
want.
Exactly.
But don't tell people what they should do.
Yeah,
I have a problem with that.
It is an issue, especially in our country.
Yeah.
And that's the reason why you feel that kind of mirrors and glorifies that. I completely get it. And maybe that's the reason which kept me a little away from watching it till now, because whatever I heard, at least from people, I believe their opinions. But having said that, yes, it's entertainment, it's a business at the end of the day. As an actor, if I'm put in the same position, yes, it's going to be a very hard call because as Bhumi said, they're very difficult to find author-backed roles. It's very difficult to find roles which probably you shoulder, the film. And to be able to deny that when you can clearly see your potential as a performer, what can come out of it versus what my morality, that's a very tough call. That only hypothetically is very easy to say this is what I would do and not do. I'm speaking strictly for myself.
Yeah.
Sure.
When that situation comes in, it's
a tough call.
That's something which you can decide only then.
You know, one doesn't want to, sorry.
No. I was also saying, you know, I felt that after Kabir Singh, maybe it spoke to the basal instinct of most men, you know, who would still, because despite your education, despite your modern ideas of equality and all that, there is one thing in a man wherein he wants to control the woman.
Correct.
Because he's been, you know, historically he's been led to believe
that he's superior
right. So I think, which is why the numbers it did.
Yeah.
But for me, the hopeful thing is that our films are doing well.
Right.
Yeah. You know, alongside.
Right.
It's okay if their business, you know, we need to add up the business of all our films to match theirs.
Right.
But I'm still saying we're in a much better place.
Absolutely.
Sure.
Absolutely.
You know, to each of you, what is the kind of film that you're dying to do, but for some reason, no one's offering you that?
I have
Avengers.
An answer.
I want to just be an Indian superhero. Avengers. That's the only one I want to do.
I just want to play a city girl. Please. Please.
Want to shoot in a city.
I have gone to MP, UP, every. I've done it all. Like, I don't think there's any. No, I shouldn't say that. I love my films and I love the fact that I celebrate Heartland India. But I want a break. Like, I wanna dress up. I just
you wanna wear a tee. I remember during our entire promotions, I used to keep saying she's Vogue, I'm Grey Shobha. But we are always given opposite roles on camera. That's how it is. That's still how it is.
I wanna do a comedy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, I don't wanna cry in my film. Yeah. I just wanna do a comedy.
I had comedy, which I think has been. I can take it off, I think, post Bala, but a warrior princess. I want to play a warrior princess.
Actually, I want to be a freedom drama. Fighter.
Costume. Really?
Costume. Wow. Drama.
Really want to, because you know, they're never like, there are no chick freedom fighters that are celebrated yet, the way, like, except Rani Lakshmi Bai.
Yeah, Avengers.
I don't know. I want to be offered something that I haven't thought of, but yeah. Chaplin is someone I want to do on screen.
Oh, yeah.
I'd love to play, but no one.
But like the two Chaplin, the sadness behind the.
Yeah, yeah, everything. You know, there was a Malayalam film and they wanted me to do it in Hindi, but it just didn't get adapted well enough. But I'd love to do Chaplin. Yeah. Just.
Yeah. I really want to see you do.
Yeah, we're all paying.
Yes to that. We're putting
it out. You've got a couple of tickets sold already.
Yeah, for sure.
How does failure hit each of you? How hard does failure hit each of you?
You know, when you've had 5 hits and then 7 flops, it hits you very bad. if it's 1 hit, 1 flop, I guess, if it's tempered like that, it's fine. But I remember wondering, you know, whether what I was doing differently. I kept going back to the films that had worked and thinking of how I made those decisions and all that. And then you realize this is just part of life. But when you're I cry a lot, I get... Poor Siddharth, he dealt with a lot during, and we had just gotten married and my film started, you know, weren't doing well. And I was like, I was tough to deal with. I'd wake up in the morning and not be pleasant to be around because I was just questioning everything.
I think every failure, every failure is like you treated. I have had 2 failures and they both have been very different the way I treated them. They're like, you know, how you get over a breakup. It depends on the relationship that you had with the film and it depends how much you believed in the film. So sometimes after you see the film, it's like, oh, okay, maybe this is not going to go the way it went. So I've had 2 completely different experiences. I remember during Shandar, it was terrible. I was, my first failure, yeah, I was like so heartbroken. I went for a holiday alone and I was like, oh my God, what did I do, etc, etc, etc. And it took me a while to come over. But with Kalank, it was very different. Because I saw the film and something just didn't feel right and it was very close to the release of the film. But I believed in the film and I wanted the film to do so well, so badly, that I just kind of went cold turkey block when the film released. I went like, oh, I'm fine. And I literally cried about it after a month. Like, it hit me like a shock because that film, I wanted it to do well for various reasons.
Also, in the case of Kalank, it wasn't just a failure. It was also a film that people really made you, I mean, people really didn't like and made everyone feel really bad about
it. No, but that's what, but same thing happened. This happened with Shandar also. Right. Like, some actors were thrown on our screens. And same thing with Kalank. But Kalank, I was too personally involved because of the director being a very close friend of mine. And I was, had too many expectations from it. And it kind of gave me a very hard truth, which was hard work doesn't always pay off.
Right.
So that was a very big thing, but it came to me only 1 month later. So I was like, oh, I'm
but
fine,
one
I've
month
got
is
over
very
it
early, yeah. 1 month is quite early.
But like, as in, I blocked it off and then a month later, I literally mourned it. And then you have to deal with it differently. Yeah.
But you said it's like a breakup. And for me, even if I was dating and then it didn't go anywhere, I'd be heartbroken. So you can imagine every film that hasn't worked has been like, oh.
But like, it is heartbreaking if you're
I think I'm a very different person that I was 5 years back when we joined 5-6 years back. And the way I dealt then was, again, as I told you, you know, it really breaks you and it really broke me. And you start questioning everything. You start questioning that, am I at the right place? I know I am, but really, what if I was really an IAS officer? What if I was simply just doing something in Chandigarh, which was the plan?
Right.
Am I with the right set of people? Is this... am I cut out for it? All those things start. But now I'm in a phase where, to give you the best example, when Bhatti Gulmeeta Chalu was released, I'd watched the film one day before, and I think I was the only one who was quiet. Mm-hmm. Shahid, Shraddha, everybody were enjoying the film. And I was just sitting, and they're like, "You didn't like the film?" I said, "No, I didn't like it." And I messaged also Shahid. I didn't say much, but I was like, but for some reason, I was very calm. Because I knew what was coming.
Correct.
I couldn't connect with it.
But that's amazing, you know, for you to be able to see.
Judge that. Yeah.
I thought I make up things in my head. I feel like, no, I'm very tired, so I'm not connecting with it.
I don't like any of my films that way because I'm always finding fault. So that this wrong, that this is wrong, there. That is totally wrong.
I'm opposite. I enjoy my films. Yeah. Like, I get so excited when a film is good. Like, I'm like, oh, ye to bahut chalne wali hai. You know, like when you see it in the edit and all. Like recently I saw the first half of Sadak and I went hugged her and my dad, I said, Papa, I'm so happy. Now I don't know what's going to happen with the end, but when you feel happy, I think I celebrated. Yeah. Otherwise, what's the point?
You know, as Alia said, I tell people, I'm always telling them this, that, you know, Son Chiria is that ex-boyfriend I'll never get over. Because the film got such love, such love, and then it was off theatres in 5 days. Like, I was like, what happened? And I think that's the only time I've really, like, dealt with failure. But as she's rightly said, it's literally like a relationship that hasn't worked. And sometimes it really hurts you and sometimes you get over it. And that time, Taapsee had Badla, which had become... And we were shooting for Sankhya, which had become, like, a massive hit. And Karthik had Luka Chupi. Our films had released on the same date. And I was like, I was just surrounded by these successful films. And I loved those films. Like, I'm being very honest. Yeah. You know, and I love you, and I was very happy for my friends that their films were doing well. But I was like, what happened?
I can imagine.
What went wrong? I said, the critics have gone, like, you know, everybody reviewed the film. I said, wow, like, what have we made? And I really enjoyed the film as well. I was clear from day one that it's not like it doesn't have any, it's not a formula film. It's going to be a tough one to get the audiences in. But then, I don't think I'll ever get over Son Chiria. Because, you know, it really hurts when a good film doesn't do well.
Yeah,
so it still pinches me. I still hope, like, you know, when it came on to digital, I was like, acha, ab na.
Yeah, but
they'll discover it now, right.
But if you feel it's a good film, it's a good film.
Yeah. So it's still a good experience.
I find it heartbreaking when you don't like your own film. Then it feels like, arey.
That's scary.
Yeah. I'm always finding faults.
Stop it.
And then I come back and tell my team, they ask me, how is it? And my reaction, nice. Let's see.
This is what she did after Sankhya. I have gone mad.
Yeah, she's crying.
I'm hugged me. Overexcited person. I love it. Like, I get very overwhelmed and I like something. And, you know, even Tushar is no different if you guys know him. He's also like, we both are a little over the top as human beings. And I looked at Taapsee and I said, are we like being delusional?
Same film? Have you seen the same?
Yeah, it's nice. I said, okay. I said, Bhumi, maybe you really need to calm down.
No, because I have seen a situation in my career in the beginning when I was in South. I had like 4 flops back to back.
So I beat you to it.
No, yeah, actually, you, the only person on this table who's got worse experience than me probably is her. I'm not very far, but yeah, I
was called the bad luck charm.
Oh God.
I didn't even reach, I didn't even make it to it. Some industry. Charm. I
was said written like that in papers.
People say really mean things.
But I think it's a good thing because they called me also a jinx.
Exactly,
It's a lucky charm.
So thankfully, it was not the beginning of my career. I had like a hit to begin with and then this happened.
Correct.
Had I been at her position, I don't think I would have probably continued. Because the way you got, what I got in between, she got in the beginning. To be called that bad luck charm, you know, you're trying to understand this world, learn a new language, learn how to act because I never wanted to be an actor. Trying to wrap your head around what is happening and then you've been labeled as a bad luck charm. Producers refuse to take you, not because you're good, not good enough, because you're just bad luck for the film. So after seeing that, I'm very wary of what I feel about my film. So I'm always like, nice.
And you know, people scare you a lot, yeah. Like, if you don't have one film that doesn't do well, they are like, now your price, like, you know, where the pay is concerned or where you're getting better opportunities, they scare you so much. And they're like, dekha, humne to bola tha, mat karo aisi picture, dark picture. I'm like, what is a dark picture? Like, what do you mean? Like, it's a film, it's a character, I believe.
Ask them to watch the last episode of the Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
That's really dark.
But they really pull you down, you know. It's amazing how Friday to Friday, somebody's perception of you just changes, like it's a different ball game altogether. And with like I've been fortunate that I've had a few releases this year. Mm. So I've been like, you have to stop taking every release of yours this seriously and what people say around you, because you will lose your
mind,
your brain matter.
True. And you know what I realized? Sorry.
No, please.
But you know what I realized is that when I was going through this period, every time I stepped out, I received as much love. And I realized that I was looking at myself differently because the film hadn't worked.
Right.
But the world wasn't necessary. Audiences are wonderful.
The audience is
They're
wonderful.
Very kind. They're very accepting.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I think I learned a huge lesson there.
I'm going to read out a quote, my dad, that he sent it to me. Because I just feel like it makes a lot of sense in this situation and I always try to think about it. He said, a maxim for an artist I would prescribe. Express, don't impress. A lot of distress comes with this lust to impress.
Wow. Yes.
So I feel like whenever you're not impressed, either as a performer or as in the film, there's something to kind of learn from it and then just like step away.
Yeah. Mm.
Because this thirst to constantly be good and constantly be successful at everything. I mean, you don't want to cheat people of their money. Like you feel a little bad, okay, coming to the theater, you promised something and then you feel like it did not deliver. So there is that certain responsibility that you feel. But beyond a point, we cannot
do anything
be obsessed with it because peace of mind is most important.
I have to tell you, when I realized the worth of that 200 rupee ticket, I was at the Chowpatty Signal and this girl came to me and said, Lelo na phool lelo, I love Mogra. So I said, haan haan de do. I had 200 bucks with me. I wasn't really carrying money. So I said, itna hai, pura de do na. She was like haggling with me. She said, Didi, aapki picture hum 200 rupay ki ticket leke jaake dekhte hain aur aap 200 rupay dene ko tayyar nahi ho, or something. Yeah. And suddenly, you know, it just gave me perspective that they're actually, everyone is spending precious time, money, energy when they go into the theatre. So previously I used to feel like, how can they come out and just diss a film, you know? But I guess it's...
You feel an ownership
to you do.
You invested that,
But I mean, coming from a middle class family, I completely, it's a family affair.
Correct.
Yeah. That's something which you plan over days and week, wo picture dekhne jayenge. So completely agree with that. And I think in today's time, all the more like everybody, like what Alia shared, it's so important to have a parallel life for yourself. It is really important. Otherwise, you will not exist. You know, even after, I'll share my personal experience, even after Bala, you know, you're getting these messages and phone calls and all those things. And for an hour, I was still on phone and hustling about, you know, further meetings and we have to do this, we have to do that. And I constantly had this frown on my face and I just kept the phone and I'm like, what am I stressing about?
I'm just coming off something.
Is, and it's not just about success. It's about something which you've enjoyed working, something which, you know, you should feel good about it. What is this whole issue and tension about worrying about future? It'll happen. But just take a little moment, just relax and absorb this time and it won't come back. So it's something very simple things at times.
I have to tell you what I did. I watched that interview of you with your sister and you said you cancelled meetings at 1:30 in the night. I messaged my manager saying, please cancel tomorrow's meeting. I was tired, I was sleepy. And you know, these people have been waiting for long and all that, and I had felt like, okay, let me just get it over with. And that gave me the thank you.
Happy that I gave you the confidence to cancel meetings.
No, because I keep feeling that maybe, you know, I'm being lazy and other actors are all. When I heard another actor say that, it was so good. I said, okay, I'm not abnormal.
Right. Have some roles taken longer than usual to get out of your system or to shake off?
You know, my first audition that I ever gave in Mumbai, that was for television. And it was some emotional scene. I had no idea like how to perform, untrained and, and all those things. And so I went back to a very emotional film from a scene from a film which I'd watched and which I'd recently watched. And I was like, okay, let me think about it. Let me think about it. And I got really emotional and I said, start. And I couldn't even, she's like, are you okay? And after cut, she's like, very good, thank you.
He was still
it's still not over. It's still not over. I picked up my bag. I couldn't say bye to anyone. I said, bye. I had to hire an auto. I said, bye. Oh my God. Like, what? Can I show you? I just couldn't stop crying.
This is hilarious.
Auto wala is very scared. What's wrong with her? I wish I could have come.
So,
But I've always wanted to cry like that after a scene. It's not happened to me, you know. Because I've heard...
See, early on in her career, she was still... Yeah.
No, but I cry for a few takes. If it goes beyond, then I can't do it.
Like, you can naturally just tear up.
No,
it just happens.
Some actors can do it beautifully.
Oh, my God.
But I can't always do it. It really depends on what my hydration levels are. Yeah. Because my eyes don't water sometimes.
But you know what happens with me? Like, right before the take, it might happen the moment they say action. And I know I have to... I just go dry. I'm like, what's going on? I'm just dry. I said, and she can tear up. I'm like, oh my God, now because of me, she'll have to give multiple takes and you're under pressure, right? When you're doing an emotional scene and she doesn't give more than 3 takes. I love giving takes. But we had our tuning. Like, right. We would settle. So I was like, Bhumi, now you're gone because now, like, this is like pressure. I just can't cry. It is very difficult for me to cry.
Give her that scene that you watched.
I just sort of admire.
But I've read about actors who like have a meltdown and all. I've always wanted that.
It never happened to me. Like, I admire. I think if there's anything that I would want from an actor, are there tear ducts? Really? Because I'm like, wow, yaar.
Shahrukh has some... method. He does something.
I've tried Alia everything. Poked my eyes. Like, done weird things. Stared at things. Stared at the sun. I've done it all.
But if you don't blink,
I can't control it only. Like, I really try and then I just look like a mental person.
That scene. I'll give you that scene.
Yeah. I really need it.
I'm trying.
She's going to tear up.
I'm trying not to blink. It comes. No, I'm wearing lenses. It won't happen.
But I cannot not blink.
During Parinita, it was my first film and I didn't know nothing. Nothing from nothing. So Dada wanted me to cry, as in Pradeep Sarkar wanted me to cry at a certain point in a song, Ratha Marito. It was on the second line. He said, you
that
have to
precise.
Imagine someone's touching you and you break down. So song would start. First few takes I gave and he was not happy. Then after that, my eye, nothing would happen.
Yeah.
So my makeup artist started giving me glycerin. And 28 takes he took and then he said the fourth take was great. You know, I was so upset. So my makeup artist went and told him, Dada, ye zara dekhiye, aapke aankh mein, ye kya ho raha hai? He gave him glycerin and Dada was jumping around.
Very nice.
And I remember I kept telling Dada, I said, Dada, if you make me cry after, you know, once you've got the shot, then I'm going to put glycerin in your eyes again. Because it's torturous,
yeah.
And sometimes it's a pressure that doesn't...
It is. I'm constantly glistening my eyes up.
Like, but do you feel that, you know, this sort of evokes this question that when, for whatever reason, you're not able to cry on set, when in the moment, it's taking you time to get into the character, is there a lot of pressure that you're keeping a unit waiting?
Oh,
I mean, do you feel, because of your lack of being able to summon up the emotion?
I think that's the reason why I, not like teen texts, zyada nahi dungi, but it's because I come fully ready to just vomit it out. Like, in Anubhav Sinha's words, I kharch ho jati hu.
Right.
So because when I started in South, I couldn't get those lines right? Mm. And I don't like to take prompting. I used to learn it up and in the beginning, there were so many retakes because I didn't know anything, okay? Mm. And I could see hundreds of people standing there, including my hero, who's a big star.
Mm.
And nahi aa rahi. So I used to feel so guilty of it. So I was like, you know, I need to be really prepared when I go for my first take. It has to be first take for me.
Right.
So that's why it ended up becoming like this today, that I'm so full when I'm there for my first take, mm. that once I give it out, then it slowly starts going. Unless you're changing the route for me.
Correct.
Then I will refresh.
Right.
But otherwise, multiple takes, I go down.
I think I don't have a process actually. At times, my first or second take, you know, like when you give a good take, there's a feeling.
Yeah, you know it.
Like,
yeah.
There's this, it's orgasmic.
Yeah. Sure.
Okay,
right?
We got it.
It is. And you just know it. And at times you can't reach it. And it's so frustrating because you're like, why am I not feeling it? But you have to succumb. Yeah, like, you know,
I'm no longer thinking about you giving a take.
It's got to
because
it
I thought she was going to say organic. Before she said it, I said yes, and she said organic.
This is
so I was like,
this is exactly.
I was like, I'm looking at
This is exactly why I was nervous. I said, Bhumi, you're going to be like, what?
I am going to. We are all feeling it now.
But don't you
guys feeling it in our heads?
But don't you guys agree? There's a feel like it, you feel so fulfilled and you feel so satisfied.
We get it, Bhumi.
But I think, you know, what I did, what earlier I would put so much pressure on myself. Oh my God, there's so many people waiting. But I, what I didn't realize is that because I'm not thinking about my scene and my character at that point, yeah. I'm taking unnecessary pressure. Mm. I need to disconnect.
Right.
The moment I disconnect and I do what I'm supposed to do, I'm in that moment, things will happen. And at times it is okay to not reach where you
and we are. That's where that we're playing with emotions.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
So
right.
It's like, don't it's not think, pressing just button. Do. Don't ab das lag raha hai, das lag raha hai, ek, teen, char. I mean, I don't know. Just
no. I used to take pressure, you know, a long time ago, but not anymore.
I have one more quote.
Please,
because it's like my dad. You know, I want to just share.
Will I follow him on Twitter? I love what he writes.
You can't expect any actor to believably play a human being when you don't receive any human contact from the director. Like, sometimes you have to draw from yourself.
Mm.
And like my dad said this to you, but sometimes you cannot draw from yourself anymore. You're spent. And if the set is not, or the people around you, or your directors are not on the same emotional wavelength as you, you don't feel protected enough. Yes. So the performance will always be, it could be good because if the writing is good, it'll be good.
It will fall short.
But it'll fall short of the authenticity if you don't have everybody in the same plane. So before, like when we were shooting as well for Sadak, every time there was an emotional scene, he would say, okay, now I want the set to match the actor's energy. Because you can't expect the actor to just be like performing where you're like, can't do that.
Yeah.
If you want that kind of, if some kind of films doesn't matter, for some takes, some scenes, it's like, oh, you don't matter, you can switch on, switch off.
Yeah.
For some moments, you have to keep that environment, like you were saying.
That protect sometimes, that vulnerability?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you have to protect it. And she may be able to do that, or I may be able to do that, even if it's not happening. But I always feel the ability or the potential you can reach when everyone is at the same plane, it's different. You start,
you know, on a completely different note, Julia Roberts said when she was making Sleeping with the Enemy, there was a scene in which she had to be in her undergarments. It was, I think, the husband's chasing her. She said, I just felt very conscious and I felt that I was much more invested in that moment because as a whole unit, she made all the men take their pants off and be on the set. Every crew
fantastic.
Member. That's the only way I felt like, you know, you're going to be as invested and I'm not going to feel like
conscious,
I'm being objectified.
Or being watched.
Next time doing a bikini scene, this is what
it's going to be.
Sabke pant nikalne wale
hain. No, that's true. It's an amalgamation. It's a collaboration. Everybody has
you
to
You can't
invest.
Do it alone.
You can't do it alone.
Yeah. No performance is your performance by yourself. It's everybody. Everybody who's standing next to you. Some AD has to cue a music at the right time.
Yeah.
The director has to say silence at the right time.
Mm.
Some
no,
words.
Line, everything.
It something like it's a.
Match.
It's not existing without everybody else.
I felt that with Suresh Triveni on Tumhari Sulu.
Very important.
He was, the entire set was in alignment with the scene.
Right.
Which then becomes so easy.
Mm.
So, you know, we would pack in a lot of work in a day. But that's because everyone was, and everyone knew the script, they knew what scene was being shot. I think those things add so much, you know.
Yeah.
That is what actually,
just respect for the process.
Exactly.
Because for the first time in my life, I snapped at someone. A few months ago at an ad film shoot, but it was a tough thing that we were doing. And there was this person who was talking right next to me. And I turned and I said, you know, if you have no respect for what goes on in front of the camera, whatever everyone is doing adds up to this.
Yeah.
And you're disrespecting that. Don't you understand it? And, you know, she felt very embarrassed and she apologized and all that. But my point is that it's still an ad film. It's okay. But on a film, when it happens, it's very frustrating.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it happens sometimes.
Yeah. Like, I remember when we were shooting for Love Stories, the scene between me and Neil, okay, that's what the film opens with.
Right.
The sex scene was very full throttle. Now, I'd read it. But when you actually go there and do it with, like, donuts between you and your donut pillows, between you and your co-actor, I was barely wearing anything. I was so nervous. And Zoya, the environment that she created with the DOP, because I was literally in nothing.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, you're putting yourself in a very vulnerable position because it's so real. You know, but the way she handled it, the way the DOP handled it, it was a close set, even the ADs, but every human every human instinct around you then starts acting up. You know, you're like, oh my God, there's suddenly a light man behind. You know, what is he going to think? I hope my spot doesn't enter the room. I don't want him to see me like that. You know, I hope like it's so unnerving. And that's why I have such love for Zoya, because I just felt so protected. And after a few takes, I was just there. I'd become like a pro. I said, okay, fine.
Finally, to all of you, what's the one thing that you wish they had told you about this job when you were starting out that they don't ever tell?
Oh, nice. That there is a very thin line in between being a public figure and a public property, and that will be blurred quite a few times in your journey.
Nice.
Yeah, I was not aware of that.
Interesting, yeah.
That you just have to be present in the moment. It's not rocket science.
Yeah.
But that presence, like they said, has to be helped by a whole lot of other factors.
It's you stressed actually a lot simple. About it initially?
Yeah, because you know, especially I'm not a trained actor and I started out late and I was like, I read all sorts of interviews of people and imagining that it was some Albert, what is that, Einstein's physics? Yeah, but I've realized it's not. It's as simple as breathing, but we ignore it.
I'm trying to think, I don't know.
It's a tough question.
Don't take yourself so seriously. Don't take all this so seriously. I had heard it, but I didn't know what it meant. I think I know it now.
No.
Don't take it so
everything
seriously.
Sure.
Don't take it.
I'm also thinking. There's so many experiences. I don't think I've still like.
Yeah, like apna karam karo.
Yeah, like just do what you're supposed to do. I think a very big thing that I've learned this year is that you need to like kind of block certain voices, which I didn't do. You know, I was like, there was too much
pressure.
Tune
into your own.
Yeah, like just figure out what really gives you happiness and just do that. You know, you need to, and especially like, you know, where your physical appearance is concerned or the kind of pressure, you know, usually that's put on an actor, male or female, you need to find what your true personality is, who you really are, and celebrate it. Love yourself. I think that's something that I've learned this year. Like, just block.
And actually have gratitude for what we get. It's very human, you know, to crib about or,
correct,
you know, to keep worrying about what I don't have. But what I have, like sitting here at this moment. And for me, sharing this table with such amazing women achievers, all of us, you. I have gratitude for it. I'm very happy. So I think that's very important to do some very basic things and to understand.
I love
I don't know.
I love this.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't wish anybody said anything to me. Everything has been a discovery, and I'm feel truly blessed for everything in my life.
Well, thank you so much. You know, I think through each of these incredible performances, and I'm not just saying that, they really every single one of these performances was beautiful, and it really gave us, in various different ways, a sense of the female experience. I think you all created incredible characters who were interesting and who were complex and who were layered, and I think the combination of it, you know, if you come away from the year feeling like, okay, I have a sense of what it must be like, you know, to be a woman in this world that we live in, which is not always perfect and which is complex and which is unfair, and you know, and you created these performances which sort of brought us closer to understanding what that's like. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Here's
for
hoping
us.
That you continue to continue to do these exciting parts that sort of speak to you, the ones that you know, really talk to you at the minute you hear them, and cannot wait to see what you do next. Thank you so much.
Thank you.